Mr. Vitale, the pressure is on both teams in this third-round tournament game between the Yale Bulldogs and the Gonzaga Bulldogs.
Hey, Brad, the NCAA tournament is the reward. After a long season of practices, tough games, and all of those other rigors, the tournament is their pinnacle.
The Bulldogs are looking to make this one a blowout early. What are the keys for them tonight, Dick?
Yeah, on a night like this, the keys are pretty simple, Brad. First, give your big men the ball. Let them attack from down low. Secondly, be monsters on the boards. Don't be afraid to get tangled up. Crash the glass. Finally, be aggressive defensively. Don't give them any open looks.
All right, there you have it. Let's get to the action. See what's in store for us. The offensive guy now is gaining position down there on the low block, Dick.
I tell you, he gained big-time position by getting the good angle, the good arm entry, and the real extension.
Good job defensively. They just won't give him any openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
Way out on top, controlling the ball. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
Gave it up. Number 15 gets the ball. Patience by the dribbler being shown as the offense is reset. And up and got it from three. Applying pressure. He looks at the hoop. Goes up for two. And he scores despite the hack. Dickie's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beats him to the spot.
Number 25 takes the pass. Trying to feed inside. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
Moving it around the perimeter. Puts it up, looking for contact. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Keeps the dribble as they set it up again. Trying to feed the low block.
A lot of good things happen.
The basket counts for the Deuce, and they'll send him to the line.
He's a meat and potatoes kind of guy, Brad.
Was the May basket the meat or the potatoes, Dave?
Hey, that was the meat and the potatoes. Now he's going to the line for the gravy.
The Bulldogs go to the line for the first time in this game. Foul shot is not good. The point guard takes the feed. Dickie's really sticking to his man defensively down there.
I tell you, doing a great job fronting him, trying to beat him to the spot, playing in front, making him throw the lob pass over the top. If you get help, you can take that pass away.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Here we go on the break. Fakes it. He's got some room. Got a man in high post. The center gets the pass. And the ball goes out of play. Number 15 makes a great move to draw the foul. Oh, and this packed house is showing their appreciation for their team.
Well, there's euphoria out there. They're really excited. They're going bananas.
The Bulldogs are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. He makes it. He misses his second shot. He takes the board. showing great patience as he waits for the reset of the offense. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. Puts up the shot. Way off target. For two. Knocks it down. Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
He goes with a baby hook and in and out. Keeps the dribble as they regroup. Had him in the paint, but went elsewhere. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post play.
They look to get it to the inside for the bucket. Can't get the shot to go. He got the steal. The pressure got to the ball handler.
Awesome ball pressure. It was too much for him, and he lost possession.
Looking for a good shot. Top of the circle, they work it around the perimeter. They still don't score. On the dribble, gives it up. The skip pass is picked off. Dumps it in.
That was really a nonchalant pass. Get that sucker out of the game, man.
Fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
Both teams looking to get things going here. He shoots from the top of the key. Off the rim and no good.
Great anticipation defensively.
It appears as though it'll be an easy two here. Goes up for two. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if you were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots. Trying to go inside.
Number 42 with the ball. Number 42 fakes the shot. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense, not allowing them to make that turn.
And now there's a whistle and a foul. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews and what she's got in store for us, Aaron.
Well, Brad and Dick, both teams appear to be really focused as they return to their benches. This is it for one of these teams, and as you guys frequently say, it's do or die, guys.
Thanks, Aaron. There's a whistle and a foul on the inside.
What a great job of putting the ball to the floor and attacking the basket, taking advantage of a slow post play.
High post flasher is open. He fires from long range. Way off target. Number 22 is emotionally pumped up.
Yeah, no kidding, partner. When you have some success, you start to gain some confidence.
He fires it up. Yale are on a nice little run at the moment, partner.
They have to remember solid defense leads to good offense, which is what we're seeing right now.
Isolated on the outside. They work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
The Bulldogs have got to continue to get him the ball.
They need to keep feeding him the ball. It's simple.
Dick, a great battle down in the low post, but I think the offense is gaining ground here.
Yeah, he's getting great inside position, has the great angle. He's got him set up perfectly for a basket. They got the 45-degree angle, which is essential in entering the ball to the post.
Tries for two.
Hey, when are these guys going to be able to make a shot?
Kicks it out. Gave it up. On the dribble, gives it up. He shoots from long range. Scorches the net. Gave it up. Good fake. For two, perfectly executed.
Dump it inside.
And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
Goes. Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man. Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Off the rim and no good. Here's the offensive drop step and a low block, but better defense.
I tell you, the defense doesn't allow him to get to the baseline.
Yale are putting together a pretty good run here.
Execution's been the key, baby.
Looking for a good shot. There's a double team waiting there.
That's the weakest double team I've ever seen, Brad.
They were a little bit too careful, I think, not to foul. The Bulldogs have a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
That spin move's not going to work against this defense.
That's a no-no, baby. Defensive player beat.
His shot blocked from behind.
He set him up nicely. He can't get the Jay to go despite running off the nice screen.
Strips the ball. He's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
They're feeling good. The momentum is on their side, and everything has fallen into place. Their body language, Dick, says it all.
Hey, why not? It's a team sport, right?
Number 15 to the line for two. Misses the first. Gets the second shot. And he'll kick it back outside. He looks for the bomb. He's money with the shot. The Bulldogs will have their fans going silly if they can get a stop here. They work it around the perimeter. He squares up down on the low block.
I tell you, teach your player to face up to get in triple threat position. You can drive, shoot, or you can pass.
They work the perimeter. Defensively, low block. Oh, nice job fronting him for the steal.
Terrific job creating the opportunity, and it really converts an offensive transition.
He takes the shot off the baseline. Way off target. Both teams looking to get things going here. Dickie really seems to be getting great position down there in the low block.
Yeah, he really is gaining possession because he gets the good angle, and they also have the good entry from the wing.
With the jump hook.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot.
Right at the circle. He misses from the outside. With a deep shot from outside. He can't get the hook to fall. Gets it to go.
Let's take a look at that last basket.
He wants a three. Off the rim and no good. He tries the three, makes it. That wide stance and the drop step.
I tell you, it's all about angles, and if you utilize that drop step, it's like a reverse pivot move.
Top of the circle, drains it. There's the rejection. Defensively down the low block, and there's a steal.
Terrific job anticipating, reading the offense, and making that steal.
On the outside. He goes for three.
He kept the ball on the floor and waited for his teammate to set that screen for the sweet jumper. Boy, that was beautiful.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat him.
Let's go up to the booth and review that one.
He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. Looking for the foul. Basket falls despite the contact. He fakes the shot. There they come with a double team to stop it.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball. There's the trap.
Number 33 is pounded on his way up. Standing ovation. You've got to love this reaction by the crowd.
What emotion, what passion. The crowd appreciates their effort.
Number 33 goes to the line for the first time. He makes the first shot. He got them both. Shot clock is dead.
They've got a shooter spotting up on the three-point line.
Turns it over. You can't be that aggressive. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
He goes to the line for the first time. Hits the first shot. He misses the second. Dick, this team is having some serious problems at the free throw line.
And it's a collective effort by all of them tonight.
And that's one too many turnovers.
Yeah, those turnovers are really a nightmare, especially when they lead to layups.
At the half, the Bulldogs are up by 7. Well, it's been a close one so far, Dick Vitale. What's your take on the play of the half?
Hey, Brad, when you look back at the first half, you have to consider this three ball, which set the tone for how the first half was going to go.
Let's get back to the action and see what happens. Gonzaga is losing in the rebounding category so far in this ballgame, partner.
Hey, any rebounding deficit is bad for this team. They're going to have to channel some of their playing energy toward hitting the boards.
Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, Brad and Dick, as we know, this is it. Now, I could hear from both teams' huddles the excitement. They are ready to play and leave it all out on the floor. This is going to be an exciting second half.
All right, thanks, Aaron. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. On the dribble, gives it up. Jump hook from the low block.
I tell you, the jump hook, so effective, especially against a big post player. Very difficult to block that shot. This defender is resilient, still applying pressure.
Makes the shot. The power forward handles the pass. College basketball is special to me for that reason right there, Dick.
The Rutgers fans are going nuts. They're going bananas, Brad. Look at that spacing.
Gave it up. Looking for contact. Number 25 makes the finger roll. Comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Takes away the pass.
Line of ball, pressure, help side. It's all there.
Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is. Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You've got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
He pulls down the board. It rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Tickles the twine. Taken away. Here they go into transition. Leans in. Drops the bucket despite the harm. On that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing him off.
Dick, not a bad drop step, but it doesn't work for him.
I tell you, just doesn't beat him to the basket, not quick enough, and a great reaction by the defensive post player.
Moving it around the perimeter, working it around the perimeter with the fake. Launches away, rims out. Had a momentary look from three-point land. Shoots! Way off target. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
Tries for two.
He made great use of the screen to put up an easy score.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Got a nice screen from left of the circle. The friendly bounces aren't going their way at the moment, Dick.
They need to get some easier looks, Brad.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. The center receives the pass. And we've got a whistle and a foul. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
Dickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
He went for the steal in the post, and they're going to count it.
Determination, baby.
Gonzaga are showing signs of a good run here, Dick.
They look like they put it together for a moment. Hey, let's see how long they can keep it up.
So he'll get an opportunity to change the scoreboard again from the free throw line.
Well, he created a foul opportunity.
That's a 10-0 run.
Surprised that they changed things up a little bit, Brad. The frustration right there.
They'll work it around the arc. On the inside.
Run him right at the screen again. What did I say? That's a 12-0 run.
There's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way?
Up and inside.
He's open if he wants the shot. The ball goes out of bounds. Boy, assist to turnover ratios are big, and that's a big turnover.
I'll tell you, they're turning the ball over too often. You can't win when you do that.
Picks off the pass. Goes up strong, and that's going to be an offensive foul.
Oh, great call by the official. He beat him to the spot. That's essential defensively.
They work the perimeter. And a slam. For the deuce. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
The shooting guard handles the feed. They work it around the perimeter. Picks off the lazy pass. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Two.
I tell you, once you get deep position like that, it's automatic.
On the dribble, gives it up. This is what you're supposed to do down low, is go up strong.
I tell you, that was great post play. Clinic 101 on how to explode to the goal.
Here's a double team. Steals the ball. Gave it up. He was looking for the call, and he got it on himself. Offensive foul.
Definitely an offensive foul, no doubt about it. He beats him to the spot.
On the dribble, gives it up. He comes away with it. They're off into transition. He shoots from right of the circle. Off the rim and no good. Gave it up in the paint with the catch. Nice execution on the spin.
I tell you, great spin move to the basket.
Gonzaga have a nice little run going here. Can they keep it up, though?
No one's proven otherwise just yet, Brad.
On the dribble, gives it up. Makes the move and goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
He's out of control, baby, out of control.
And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Nice high post screen.
That comes off. Might have been some contact on the shot.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Reverses the ball after having a guy in the post. Takes the pass in the paint. Tries for two.
Got to make that, baby. Had a wide open angle. Have a chance to lay it on the glass for easy dish.
Picked off. The power forward receives the ball for the bucket.
I'd say great footwork, too, to create that opportunity. And then he's got the touch. What an offensive play.
Great defense. Goes up for two. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Well, guys, down here on the sidelines, there is such intensity from both benches. Both coaches are emphasizing shot selection and defensive stops. So important here in the second half.
He shoots from right of the circle. He attempts the trifecta. Off the rim and no good. Jumped in front to take it away. There's the fake, and now they'll bring it up. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Dick, this crowd will go silly if they can get some points this trip.
Up and inside.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
The Bulldogs have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
Brad, he's on fire.
Big finish coming here, partner. I'm not going anywhere.
Hey, down the stretch, there are so many factors that could become the difference maker. Turnovers, missed free throws, rebounding. I wonder what it will come down to in this game.
Oh, what a strip, Red.
This place will be in complete chaos if this defense can get a stop right here. Good defensive stance there against the spin move.
Well, the key is to beat him to the spot, and he did a great job. He anticipated that spin move.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, guys, the battle in the paint has played a major factor in this game and is probably some of the reason why they have this lead. If things don't change in a hurry, this game could get ugly, guys.
Well, I think she's right about that, Richie.
I'll tell you, Aaron's exactly right. Post play is essential if you're going to be effective.
For two, perfectly executed.
Back it up, back it up. We'll see that one again.
He missed on the steal. That's going to be the offense's game.
Yes, sir. They got the advantage right there once he misses that gamble.
Looking for a good shot. Goes up for two. Rims out. They get the ball down low, and he hips up with his man, and down he goes.
Hey, Brad, that's a flop. That's Mr. Flop right there. Don't call that, baby.
2, grabs it. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that. Here's the block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
On the outside. He shoots from outside. He nails the shot.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps.
Defense extended the old game long. There's that pressure on the ball.
The defender right on his hip, and I think he's holding his ground, Dick.
Doing a great job. I tell you, doing a phenomenal job not allowing the offensive player to seal them off.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in, and a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
The Bulldogs are going to call a timeout. And with that, we got a break. Let's check in with Aaron Andrews. Aaron?
Well, at this point in the game, it's about being on the same page. Each player should know what the objective is for the upcoming possession. Offensively, you must know who the number one option is, while defensively, the type of defense you're going to play or whether to foul. Time is of the essence, Brad.
All right, thanks, Aaron. Working it around the perimeter. For the deuce. Can't get the shot to go.
Very soft defensively, no pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. With the catch, nice execution on the spin.
I've had a great spin move to the basket.
He shoots from the top of the circle. He misses from long range. Well, Dick, it looks like they're going to spend a little bit of time fouling right here.
Right, Brad. They have to foul in order to stop the clock, Brad.
To the line. He makes the front end of the 1-1. Gets the second shot. A lot of time to go now, Dick, on a 7-point lead.
That's right, Brad. A lot of time. They don't need to start forcing shots.
Goes in. And the clock stopped with a foul.
Hey, now it's a matter of clock management, Brad. They have to foul in order to get back in this game.
Well, Dick, there's a look at the foul situation.
Well, you know, Brad, a lot of times the first team to the bonus will get the advantage. That means they're playing aggressive basketball. It means they get to the charity stripe quicker and have an opportunity to rack up some easy points.
Hits his second.
They really need a score here to turn this into a two-possession game.
See what they set up there. Dick, 6-point lead here.
They have to keep applying the pressure if they want to win this one, Brad.
He looks for three. Off the rim and no good. And yet another foul as they're just trying to hang on here. And there's a look at the foul situation so far.
Hey, know when to foul and when not to foul is a great skill to have. Coaches should always be communicating this with their team.
Timeout on the floor. Coming out of the timeout, I'd expect we're going to see more focused play on both sides.
One would assume so.
He takes the three. Rims out. Steals the pass. Launches it. Off the rim and no good. Dick, I think the better team won. We can say that. And it's heartbreak for the other club. But, you know, you got to win it and keep on going to get to that final Monday night neighbor.
Well, the better team won because they protected the basketball. They made sure they converted on the free throw line. They did all the little intangibles we talked about. And that was the difference in the game.
The Bulldogs makes it three in a row with an impressive third-round victory.
Hey, the way they're playing, Brad, this team is going to be hard to deal with entering the Elite Eight.
That's going to do it for us, folks. Thanks for being along. For Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler.